So what I'm not going to be talking about is prescribing how to write a piece of qualitative market research so that you can put in a paper and you will get accepted in a journal. That's not what I'm going to do. But what I'm going to do is to look at the best practices available and go to the best practices to see what kind of fundamental things we have so that we can learn from those fundamental things and then we can use them as a guide or as a framework or as a fundamental issues that we need to address in terms of writing that valuable paper to make it publishable in a qualitative research journal or in a general marketing journal. Now, if we were given information to do it, if we're given the information to do it, we would know how to do it. Not just once, but all the time, every time. So if we had a guide, everybody would know how to write that piece of publishable market research. Now, it doesn't work that way, because we do know that people are different. We do know that social media changes a lot of things for a lot of customers and for a lot of suppliers. We do know that the technology is moving very fast, as our previous speaker had already indicated in the retail channels. And we do know that the environment in which we're living, the political, economic, and marketing environment, the social cultural environments, are different. And things are changing very fast. And in this connected world of ours, things have changed so fast that even when we do a piece of quantitative study or a piece of qualitative study, we need to update about what's happening on the ground. And we need to update on what we're reading. So there's no way that one can prescribe a guide for actually writing a piece of paper, a manuscript, to be able to publish in a journal. Because things change all the time. I'll give you an example about brand narratives. I mean, we're talking about brands and social media, talking about how suppliers have changed their website design, talking about how suppliers present their brands on the website, and about how they talk about brands and communicate with customers on the website. Now, you might be able to do a piece of qualitative research about consumers then and now, but by tomorrow, or in a week's time, that brand narrative would have changed.